my world. Won't you come on in? Miracles, I guess, still happen now and then. Step into my heart, leave your cares behind. Welcome to my world, built with you in mind. Knock and the door will open. Seek and you will find. Ask and you'll be given the key to this world of mine. I'll be waiting here with my arms unfurled, waiting just for you. Welcome to my world. Just for you. Welcome to my
world. Hello everyone, my name is Omega the Real, or Meg if you want to keep it short and simple. And before we get this video started, I think we have to address the elephant in the room. What the oh, it's past 1 minute. Fuck happened here. What? Over 9,000 views in the first week and almost 100 subscribers as well. What happened? Genuinely, how did I have no idea how this happened? It just the unboxing blew up and I can't say this enough. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For everyone that watched that, that was insane. And hopefully, if you're all still around, I can still please you with this review. Not with this guy. Let's get this guy out of the way. These guys. So before we start this, thank you so much for all the growth in the past week. It has been absolutely incredible, and I can't thank you all enough. So anyways, let's give this a proper introduction. Hello everyone, my name is Omega the Real, or Omega if you want to keep it short and simple. And today we're going to be taking a look at the SH Monsterarts Godzilla Kong, the New Empire, Kong, and Godzilla 2024. Without further ado, let's get this review started. We'll save the best for last because I got a lot to talk about this guy. So, let's start with the Monkey Man. So, as a disclaimer, yes, I am aware that these guys are repaints. These aren't new molds, these are repaints. And there's a lot of controversy around that, and I want to talk about that first with these guys. So, what's my opinion on the matter? I honestly think it's not a huge deal that people are making it out to be. Because this isn't the first time something like this has happened. At least, in my opinion. Repaints of original slash retooled molds have always been a thing in multiple fandoms, and SH Monsterarts is no different, just considering the amount of times this guy's been repainted is not even close to a joke. But every repaint, well, most repaints, have a purpose so that you get a different version of the character you want in the colors that you want it. And SH Monsterarts is no stranger to this concept, and I don't know why people are making this such a big deal. I'm pretty sure the huge problem with it is that we didn't get these versions of the characters. And yeah, this is the biggest problem with it. And I'll tell you why this isn't bad. It's because they're making us wait, you imbecile. Just because we never got an official announcement on an evolved SH Monsterarts Godzilla or a Beast Glove SH Monsterarts Kong doesn't mean they're not happening. Things like this happen all the time, and let's give a little lesson on this before we start. This little guy right here is Earthrise Starscream. He is a pre-tool, which means he's a character used and then repainted later on to get different versions of. This looks like an addiction, but I swear I could stop. But what I mean to say to this is SH Monster Arts has been doing the same thing for a while, and only now people are complaining. So in conclusion, obviously they're gonna release a Beast Glove Kong and an Evolved Godzilla sometime down the line. But it's not gonna be right now, so if you wanna get the Hayatoys one, you can get it, I guess. But what I mean to say is, think it twice before you say something, I guess. And for those extremely pissed off that these are just, oh, repaints of figures I already have, you don't need to get them. You don't ever need to buy them. It's always a choice you can make. Obviously, I don't have 2021, so I got this guy instead. But we're getting too off topic, so let's get back to the monkey. Now, after yammering on for about 5 minutes about why people are dumb and why you shouldn't just take everything as you see it, let's finally talk about it's the monkey. SH Monsterarts Kong here is a fantastic example of a repaint done well, and not something like a frozen version of Shin Godzilla. And what I mean by that is that painting and sculpting on this thing is absolutely amazing. Kong looks so good. The painting on this guy is very improved since the 2021 release, giving him a charcoal black, a subtle brown look to the fur, with the gray highlight symbolizing he's older. And okay, maybe I'm looking too much into it. It's just a really damn good paint job. And this isn't a sculpt difference, but they added a scar in which Godzilla shot him with his atomic breakfast of GVK. They painted that on. And you can actually see it in a few scenes, so kudos to Tamashii for actually getting accuracy on this thing, for the most part. Sculpt, on the other hand, is generally good. His fur detail looks really nice and well done, and it just looks fantastic in any photo you get him in. But there is one thing I'm a little upset about, and it's the face. I don't know why, what this face just doesn't do it for me. I'm not sure why. It just feels inaccurate and it doesn't look right. And honestly, the face that came with the 2021 release of the San Diego Comic-Con version, or 2022, whatever you want to say, looks a lot better than this one. So maybe I should get that one after. But I think I'm complaining too much because overall, the sculpt and paint, like I said, is fan-friggin-tastic. Am I blazing too much? In short, Kong is just amazing to look at in not a weird way, and his painting is really well done, but there is one area where it's bad, and it's the axe. Now, I should bring this up now because I should bring this up now, but the axe looks fantastic paint on this thing. Woo! But that's not the paint I'm concerned about. It's the paint down here that really bothers me. If we can do a cut real quick. As you can see on the base of the bone right here, it chips bad, and there's one huge reason for this. This thing. To put the Kong glove into his hand, you have to really force it in, and it rubs off real easy, and that's a shame. Overall, paint on Kong was fantastic, but this brought it down from a 10 to a 7, honestly. But that's enough about paint. Let's talk about movement. So Kong's movement here is, as you would expect, pretty fantastic. He's got some pretty good movement at his head here on a multiple set of ball joints here, so you can really get him moving around. And God damn it! His arms too are pretty well done. Everything here that you see is ball jointed, so you could pretty much go crazy with this. And all of it feels pretty fluid. The only piece that really bothers me is this diaphragm. This thing here is not that solid, but I don't want to complain too much. I really like this line really that much. But if you're able to utilize it correctly and not break anything on here, you can actually get him to do some pretty cool poses with it. And he can even bend forward a lot like that. His legs as well, contrary to the 2021 release, from what I've seen on the internet, I swear I'm an expert on this, his legs are very smooth. They will not break. Although, this one has a tendency to pop off. Not break, so that's an improvement at least. But it is still a problem that needs to be fixed. I might do something with this in the future, I don't know. But overall, Kong has a lot of movement in this guy, and I forgot to count how many joints there are, so you're not getting that official number from me. But it's a lot. He can't stand that well, but screw it, he's still freaking fantastic. And unusually for SH Monsterarts, yes, I can also throw shade at that too, just because I love him. He comes with a ton of accessories that makes him really worth the $75+ price tag. That's the first time that's getting brought up. Let's see how long I can keep that counter for. So first up, he's got these closed fist hands, which work really well if you want to throw hands with the Godzilla that you also bought for $75+. And he's also got a pair of open hands, great for relaxed poses, or if you want to recreate that scene with Godzilla in Egypt, in which case you can go right ahead and do that. And he even has a pair of knuckle draggers, so where you can get him completely going full monkey, and honestly, I kind of like this pose a lot, it's really fun to do with. And Kong even gets a pair of open hands that we've discussed earlier to hold the also thing we've discussed earlier, the battle axe! Kong's axe, Kong's ancestral axe, Godzilla axe. Is there a name for this thing, or are we going to keep calling it some random thing until the director decides? This thing is sick as hell, though, I won't lie. The details on this thing are freaking amazing. And even the paint, besides the bone part that we already discussed, is really well done as well. And a little flash warning for anyone who's kind of sensitive to bright light. This thing's also transparent. Something that the other Godzilla will have to talk about in a minute about. This thing looks great on the light too. You love the blue on that. Just love it. And to finish off the look, Kong even comes with an angry face that we just slap on there. And Kong there just looks absolutely amazing. Probably the way I'm going to display him overall. Because that angry face just adds so much character and emotion to the guy. I mean, come on, if he only came with this, we'd all be pissed off even more. But I think this face just works so well. Still kind of want the other one, though. Overall, Kong here has a fantastic amount of display options with all the accessories you get with him. And the axe, too, adds a very, very fun play piece as well. Honestly, though, I don't think there's any other accessory that we could have gotten with this guy that makes him any better. Besides maybe a beast glove, but we already know that's another version coming soon. Probably, maybe. Overall, Kong's accessories are a solid 8 out of 10, despite the grabby hands being laced with acetone stripping the axe of its paint. It's actually really fun to swap out the hands and the heads and the axe and use it around a little bit. This is honestly pretty damn good, but what's a little disappointing is his size. Despite having to be an action figure for a 330 something foot tall monkey, this guy is actually really small once you get him in hand. Because here he is next to the Playmates Evolved Godzilla, the Playmates Pre-Evolved Godzilla with Heat Ray, the SH Monster Arts 2019 King of the Monsters Godzilla, and the Playmates Kong with Beast Glove. $75. Who's keeping track of how many times I said the price? But despite having to pay so much more for so much less, Kong here is filled with a lot to cover that price, honestly. I thought I would have a harder time justifying Kong than Godzilla, but his articulation more than makes up for $75. Who's keeping score here? I asked that already. Overall, Kong here is a solid 8 out of 10. I'm giving it a confident 8. Because there could be so much more given to this guy, like an extra head, 2022 release, that could have honestly made this guy a 9 or a 10. And the acetone-filled hands is another problem as well. But overall, I'm confident in giving him an 8 because this guy genuinely is fun to mess around with. Overall, my finishing thoughts, Kong is just fantastic. I can't stop saying that in this review. He's great to mess around with, and I didn't think I'd had this much fun with him as I would the other figure. And speaking of which, I think it's time Without further ado, to introduce the moment you've all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, Godzilla. I'll be more about check than a million. Now fuck that bitch and you dream. Now fuck that bitch and it's fair. Make me so damn mad and fair. If there are any words in the English dictionary I would use to describe my perfect feelings for this guy, I would use them now. Notice how I'm not saying anything? Godzilla here is nothing short of absolutely fucking perfect. Except paint and sculpt work here on Godzilla 2024 is absolutely incredible. The amount of work that Tamashii put into this version of the mold is pretty fucking clear if you couldn't see already. And the sculpt is the same as the last few Godzillas, but we're still gonna talk about that here. Godzilla here is incredibly accurate to how he looked in, well, versus Kong and X-Kong, due to that being the same design. But the sculpting, man! The amount of detail they put in here is absolutely incredible. And that paint. Oh, that paint. It was never my favorite color that they used for the 2021 release, that teal greenish looking color. Mainly because when they actually did the final model, it kind of looked like a bootleg to me. But the spines on this guy blow that thing out of proportion. And every single spine here is painted too, all the way from the basically top of his head to the very last spike is covered in this very, very rich metallic blue. But the paint comes at a cost. If you're not careful like I was, you can actually have these spines bash into each other when moving around his tail. And as you can see by that little black mess right there, these ones have been rubbing together for a bit. And it's really unfortunate that it has this problem. But it makes sense, the amount of paint here kind of makes chipping a problem. But if you're not paying attention, you barely even notice anything's wrong at all, and good. What do I have to say other than this thing's basically perfect? But the teeth could always be better. Monsterarts has always had a problem with the teeth being suboptimal. But here, I don't really mind it, and it kind of blurs away once we get into the fact that this thing is $75. That's another one to the count. I just want to highlight these larger spines as well, because on camera, they come off very differently as opposed to in hand. So, you can see that they tried using what looks almost like a Gundam marker to highlight the lines. And I'd say that works for a bit until you get to the sloppier ones, which unfortunately doesn't look the greatest. But if you put it far enough away, does it even matter if it looks that bad up close? And there's even some level of shading too. If you can really pay attention there, you can see what's almost a basically ballpoint pen blue, almost purpley color. I think it's more obvious up here, you can see it right there. But there's some level of shading on here, that's granted. And then once you get to the tail, it is just covered in paint. Up to a certain point in which only the spines are colored, which is fine. This just feels like overdoing it at this point. But let's continue talking about sculpt. Sculpt here on SH Monster Arts in general will always, most of the time, be absolutely fantastic, and on this guy it's no exception, especially on the spines. I gotta stop talking about those, but overall he looks incredible from basically any angle as long as you pose him correctly. But the close-up scales and all the little parts, just he looks authentic. But there are a few paint apps missing. Like on this guy, there's no brownish gradient here on the chest like there is on his original. So you see that you can tell that there's sort of some sort of brown going on in there, which is absent on here. But instead, we do get a much darker Godzilla as compared to 2019. And I, for one, will take that over this color. He's kind of Mitch matched, but we love them still. We love them. And putting these guys together, it's like actual night and day. The colors are just wildly different on each other and subtle at the exact same time, which is a plus and a minus considering who you are and what your opinions are. But overall, I think 2024 is still a major improvement. But we haven't even gotten to the accessories. Getting a better look on the head, it's actually pretty well done. Despite having no pupils, there is no complaint about having weird googly eyes on this guy, so he already gets a bonus. But I just love how the blue continues all the way up to the tip of his head, and his mouth looks decently enough, and all of it looks incredible. Even the nails on his hands and his feet look great. And overall, this is just a very, very damn good-looking Godzilla. Now, articulation on Godzilla here is pretty well done, while being suboptimal in a few places, so let's take a look at this guy. So to start him off, he's got a bunch of ball joints in his neck here, which can move around for some pretty damn good poses. And is it me, or he's more animalistic than usual? I don't know. He feels very, very crocodile-y right now. And using all those points together, I actually get him to look all the way up, just like the original 2019 release. Which is great to see that they didn't get rid of that pretty impressive articulation. And because of some improved jaw ball joints on the internal side of the figure, he can look really far down. Which, if you want to create the Godzilla drilling a hole into the center of the earth scene, you're more than welcome to do so. And while we're on the topic of this pose, he does have some good movement in his core. Getting to move these guys all up and down and even side to side. It's a really tight side to side, so I wouldn't recommend doing that too much unless you want to move over a spine, in which it almost feels like a ratchet joint, but it's not. It's a ball joint, so don't test your luck on that. And his arms too are pretty well posable. This one has a weird posing issue to where it just sticks out like that, but if you overlook that, he's got some pretty nice hands. His elbows are great, he's got pretty good articulation on his arms, and the hands we'll get to later, but he comes out of box with these hands, and they're pretty fun to mess around with. Very, very crocodilian. Moving along to his legs now, he's got a lot of posability here. So he can turn all the way around, and it's a very tight movement, so this guy's tight, tight, tight. So if you're worried about anything popping off, nothing's gonna pop off on his body. This guy is solid as a brick. And there's this little thing that's loose, but I think this has been loose with basically every Monsterarts release of this design. So it just shakes around. It's fine. And now, the tail. Over 20 points of articulation here, and it is absolutely incredible. I mean, at first when I got this out of the box, it was a very, very quiet movement, but now that you mess with it more, it's getting the creaky sound that I always thought you'd hear, because if you listen to this one, that guy's creak central. That's what I thought it'd sound like out of the box, but it didn't, and I'm okay with that. So he's got 20 points, like I said, and they are just incredible up to a point. Yeah, his tail pops off at the base, and it gets pretty annoying when you're trying to do, like, very, very natural S-curves. So, that's a downgrade for me, considering the tail. I've never had this problem on my 2019 release, so it being here confuses me a little bit. Mold degradation is my best option for what that means, so that's unfortunate. And the one last complaint I have on this guy, a floppy tail. Now, if you really try and be a dick to this thing, you can attempt it to curve up at that point, but I wouldn't hold it against you if you weren't able to do the same. That's unfortunate that he's not able to get a proper, well, you can kind of do that. At the end of the day, that's not what you want. You want a higher pose, but he's loose in this area, so it's a little unfortunate. But it doesn't honestly bring it down. I'm not trying to do high S curves with this Godzilla. I'm trying to do that, and that is basically able to be done. So overall, his articulation is a 9.5 out of 10. If it wasn't for this unfortunate ass, very loose joint in the tail, this would be better. But it's not better. So, that kind of sucks, doesn't it? Now, I can admit when there's problems, SH Monsterarts always has room to improve on every release, and this guy is no different. But overall, his articulation is fantastic, and you can get him to a bunch of poses as seen in that sick-ass intro. If you didn't subscribe, why not? That was pretty cool, no? But overall, the guy's sculpt, paint, articulation is incredible. But like most Godzillas, how are his accessories? Let's get to it. Before we actually get to the accessories, I did forget to mention this. Again, flash warning for anyone. Unfortunately, this Godzilla does not have translucent spines. That's a shame, because a Godzilla from almost 9 years ago does, and a Godzilla from this day doesn't. That sucks to point out, but I still love this thing regardless. Now, unusual for an SH Monster vs. Godzilla, this version of the Monster vs. Godzilla actually is the one that released with the most. So, that's another plus for him. Now, out of the box, Godzilla actually comes with these very scary looking hands. And they were the ones that came with the 2021 release, which is a repaint of this one. So, of course, this one came with it. But if you don't want this Godzilla to be that aggressive, you can always switch him out with these relaxed hands. They are different enough to be warranted, and the articulation is about the same. But getting these suckers in there is a little bit of a challenge. But once you loosen them up enough, they actually work pretty well. And they're pretty cool. I mean, they're basically a one-to-one copy of the hands that came with this Godzilla. So if you can see them, they're basically the same hands, just reprinted. Which is fine. Again, more accessories is nice. Just like Kong, it helps justify the 75-plus price point. Who's keeping track? Look at the number up there. But was it needed? Were extra hands really needed? Because I don't think they were. But whatever helps inflate the price, I guess. And of course, with this guy being all spit fiery, he of course comes with a breath effect adapter. What is the real name for this thing? I don't know. It's a jaw piece for Godzilla in order to do the whole King of the Monsters poster image. It's pretty cool. It's got better paint on the teeth than the actual Godzilla itself, which is a little embarrassing, but let's put this thing on and we'll get to the rest. Now, of course, this isn't complete. This is just one part of the bigger puzzle, but it just looks like Godzilla's barfing, and that's because our next accessory is the atomic breath beam. Oh, hell yeah. Now, not counting other releases like repaints and exclusives, this is the third version of this beam that we've gotten from the Monsterverse line. The first one being the Spitfire version, which is these really, really weird teal-colored greenish silver. And I don't really like this color. But then 2019 also gave us a version of this blast effect, which had a more lighter blue color with the same silver put on there. And finally, in 2024, Tamashii decided to switch it up a little bit by giving us actual white paint on this guy instead. So you can differentiate these colors by how you look. And on camera, 2019, 2024 don't look that different, but 2015, whatever you want to call it, is definitely the most out of place here, to say the least. So, just like the 2019 figure, if you have that one, in order to put this in his mouth, you kind of just stick it in there. And it holds, actually. I'm not sure how well. I'm barely use this piece myself, but overall, it's holding pretty well right now, so I'm actually surprised it's pretty pretty well on camera. And you can do whatever you want with this thing. If you really want to, you can stick this guy all the way up in the air and get the 2019 pose effect. I'm running out of things to say, so what else can I say about this breath effect? If you don't want to use this, the breath effect part, like I did because I lost mine from the 2019 because I'm dumb, you can actually get a stand. This is the one from the 2015 Godzilla. And plug it in on a little hole on the bottom. You could see it pretty clearly right there. And it just plugs in and you could just position it however you want. And it looks like Godzilla shooting breath again. So everything's saved if you got a couple extra bucks to spend on a stand. Because this guy does not come with one. Which I guess is a little predatory, making you buy another stand. But he comes with a mouthpiece to already deal with that. So honestly, the stand isn't required, but it would be nice to have it also. Overall, 2024's accessories here are not that bad, considering this is the most a mainline-ish SH Monsterarts Godzilla has gotten ever. It's actually pretty damn good, despite being kind of wimpy, such as slightly bigger hands, a mouthpiece, and a breath effect. I think it's just all he needs. A stand would be cool too, but I think we're reaching when it comes to that. Well, that's it for our accessories. Let's finally move on to size comparisons. Overall, when comparing the 2024 release to other versions of Godzilla from his many different toy lines, he actually stands up pretty well against those guys. So how about we start doing some comparisons? So here's 2024 next to his 2014 Spitfire version, the Playmates GXK Godzilla with Heat Ray, the Playmates GXK Evolved Godzilla, the Playmates GXK Beast Glove Kong, the SH Monsterarts Godzilla Kong The New Empire Kong 2024, and the SH Monsterarts 2019 King of the Monsters Godzilla. And for shits and giggles, I guess, here's Doug compared to him. Overall, Godzilla here is both an upgrade and a downgrade. Upgrades that he has some incredible paintwork here, and the accessories are much more than any Godzilla we've gotten from the Monsterverse so far. But considering his joints have gotten loose over time due to the mold degrading over the years, it kind of sucks that this thing was almost a perfect predecessor to the 2019 and, if you want to call it, 2021 release as well. But the negatives here do not outweigh the positives at all. I still think this guy is absolutely fantastic. And if you think he's just another wave filler just to wait for the GXK official guys, then I'd get mad at you because this thing is still pretty fantastic even when compared to its older releases. Overall, most of my complaints are just honestly nitpicks that shouldn't be taken as honest critiques, and make your own opinion of it as you will, but if you want to hear mine, I think this is absolutely one of the best figures being put out this year. Better than most of the stuff Haya is, and if you're a Haya supporter, you're just someone that really misses NECA, if you want to be honest. Because at the end of the day, honestly, it doesn't matter whichever one you choose, Haya, SH Monsterarts. All of them are still pretty damn good figures. And if you want to pick this guy up too, I highly recommend it. You can also get him at Big Bad Toy Store right now. Awesome that they were the first ones in the country to get him first. So shout out Big Bad Toy Store, not sponsored. And putting Kong and Godzilla right next to each other too look absolutely fantastic. This pair has to be bought together. I'm not saying you should buy them together, but come on, don't tell me this looks absolutely incredible. Overall, my final thoughts with both of these figures are that they are absolutely fantastic. Straight down. These guys are incredible releases that Tamashii and Bandai, SH Monsterarts, whatever you want to call them, have put out. And honestly, this has almost got me into collecting SH Monsterarts again. These things have left a huge impression on me. And they may not leave my Toy of the Year spot for a while. I don't see anything coming out that could beat these things. Because the playability, the sculpt, the detail, the paintwork, the articulation, the accessories. These guys have the perfect amount for these toys. I don't know what else to say about these guys. These are fantastic releases. And I'm going to get a lot of comments saying, what about this, what about that, what about this you mentioned. This is my opinion, and I may be sounding like a glazer, but I don't mean it as that. I genuinely do like how these toys are done and all the stuff Tamashii's been putting out, and I've been meaning to pick it up again, but I think these might have actually opened the gateway to that. My final point, if you do not have the 2021 releases of these guys, I highly recommend picking up the 2024 releases. Because these guys, despite being lazy-ish repaints, are still some pretty, pretty damn fantastic figures, in my humble opinion. Once again, I do want to say thank you so much for helping us pass 530 subscribers. I was kind of in and out of my studio all day, and I was just checking those numbers as time went on, and I honestly didn't expect to reach a number that high that quick. But with the unboxing almost hitting 10,000 views as of recording this, I have so much I want to say, but I don't know how to say it. So I'll just say it in a way I do know. Thank you. Thank you for supporting the channel. Thank you for watching, liking, and commenting. Every one of you that watched this video, thank you. It really means a lot to me. Well, that was it for this video. My name is Omega, and I will talk to you all later. That took way longer than I thought. Well, now that I'm done with this review, who's next? I don't even know if I should consider you two.